St. Francis and Robert Morris. Two teams on a possible crash course to a Northeast Conference title. The Terriers won this matchup by 5 last week in Pittsburgh. Today, they'll have a rematch in Brooklyn, and it's coming up next. Pryor's going to take it all the way to the rack. Goes glass, rebounded by Cannon. And back we go the other way. Quickly for Ulmer, and he lays it home. That's Stephen Bennett. Hands off to Stewart, who hit a 3 the last time down the floor. Drives, dishes it off for Bennett for the slam.
And that's a great penetration and kick. The last two times in the lane, Robert Morris got their shot blocked. This time they draw the defender and they drop off for the easy 2. But those in-between shots, really moving the ball and knocking them down.
Fall with a good look for Cannon and the slam. Stewart off the dribble drive. Kicks it to the left side, and the 3 is dropped in. Colonial ball with a new 35, up by 3. This is Reed, off the step back. Sweet shot, second basket for 4. Stewart pops, hits the bucket, and the foul. Jones, Cannon off the fumble. 15 to shoot, and Jewel bails him out with a 3. Andre Frederick, the freshman out of Detroit, with his first bucket of the day, the bucket of the foul, as Andy Fall answers. St. Francis with the ball, down by 3. Jewel thought about the 3 and then pulled it back. Instead, he fires here and hits. We've got a tie ball game. Apollon. Down low for Bennett, no, and then the follow goes. Brent Jones all the way to the rack. Cannon with the offensive board. The putback, the bucket, and the foul. Cannon has 20. We are tied at 60, and he will go to the line looking to give St. Francis the lead. Both coaches stress being smart with the ball and clean with the ball. Well, Dave, that's not clean.
No, here we got St. Francis in transition.
Jewel takes advantage with the bucket and the foul. Pryor to the baseline, cut off, and Fall comes up with the rejection, but Robert Morris maintains possession. Lucky Jones for 3, and he sinks it. The Colonials take a 1-point lead. 2 seconds to go. Jones with the floater off glass does not go. Robert Morris has the win. The Colonials steal one, 67-65.
Paul back here with a relieved Coach Stuhl. Take us through that timeout you draw to play. It worked out just like you liked, right? The beta 3.
Yeah, exactly. You know, we executed the play we wanted. St. Francis defended it really well, which is what they do. You know, that's their calling card. And we kind of were in a scramble mode. I thought we had a little bit of advantage. I thought about taking another timeout. And, you know, Lucky Jones, being the senior he is, he raised up and hit a huge shot. And then our defense held strong enough to get a miss there from Brent Jones at the end.
Yeah, talk about that. A lot of people don't realize 9 seconds, an eternity. You're up 2. You're on the road. What was your mindset on that defensive play?
We talked about not fouling, obviously. We talked about trying to slow him down early. That's why we had that, you know, little bit of pressure to try and slow him down. And then, you know, just wall up and try and make a shot. And Dave Apollon, another senior, you know, kept his chest in front of Brent Jones, which is not easy to do. And, you know, we were fortunate the ball rimmed out.
You know, you talk about the NEC, your number one seed, so important in this league. You lost at home to these guys. You had to get this one. What's this mean for you?
You know, in some ways, I think, it was a similar game to the game in Moon, and they made the plays down the stretch. And today we were fortunate enough to make those plays.
Well, that's what it's about. You make plays, you make shots. A lot happier coach here in Brooklyn. It would be a nice ride back to Moon Township.
Yeah, it's real simple, right? Make plays, make shots.